Our programs offer many languages. Please visit suprememastertv.com/schedule.
Nos programmes offrent plusieurs langues. Veuillez visiter suprememastertv.com/schedule.
Nuestros programas ofrecen varios idiomas. Visiten suprememastertv.com/schedule.
برنامه‌های ما شامل زبان‌های بسیاری است. از این وبسایت دیدن فرمایید suprememastertv.com/schedule.
Refugee artists, ambassadors of peace, culture, and humanity. Part 1 of 3. Continue watching to find out more.
Salam means greetings in Shuni, one of the languages spoken in Gorno-Badakhshan, an autonomous region of Tajikistan. Gracious viewers, I am Safsan. The open-minded people of Gorno-Badakhshan appreciate the diversity of all the beautiful cultures around the world. Welcome to our show, Refugee Artists, Ambassadors of Peace, Culture and Humanity, Part 103. June 20th was declared World Refugee Day by the United Nations. By definition, a refugee is someone who fled his or her home and country due to a well-founded fear of persecution because of his or her race, religion, nationality, membership in a particular social group, or political opinion. Throughout the long history of humankind, there have been refugees all over the world as the result of conflicts or natural or human-made disasters. Many overcame challenging circumstances to become valuable contributors to their home and host countries, positively reshaping the global economic, cultural, and social landscapes.
History is full of remarkable individuals who were refugees. From Joseph of Canaan in the Bible, Genesis 41, who interpreted Pharaoh's dreams and saved Egypt from the 7 years of famine,
to modern-day geniuses like Dr. Albert Einstein, whose famous theory of relativity and other scientific laws still remain prevalent today.
In our three-part show, we pay tribute to some of the distinguished artists who happen to be refugees. These special individuals imbue their struggles, love, and longing into moving creations of music, art, and literature that endure the test of time.
Dante Alighieri, considered one of the greatest Italian poets, wrote the epic poem Divine Comedy while in exile. Viewed as a significant literary masterpiece in the world, it initiated a new epoch of modern literature. One of the most important authors of French Romanticism, Victor Hugo, wrote Les Misérables and Toilers of the Sea when he was exiled, and published 93 shortly after.
The deep humanity within the stories continue to inspire countless generations of artists and readers.
Frédéric Chopin, beloved pianist, poet, and composer, created his most beautiful piano compositions while staying in Paris, France, due to civil unrest in Poland, his home country.
He never lost touch with his Polish origin and poured the emotions of exile life into melodious music that still resonates within the hearts of innumerable people today.
From the late 1920s to the late 1940s, political turmoil and unrest in the world forced huge waves of immigrants to leave their homelands and seek safe shelter in foreign countries.
Among these refugees were many talented artists that have enriched our lives with their musical contributions. Hungarian-born Jewish orchestral and operatic conductor Sir Georg Solti is an excellent example of the positive impact to society one refugee can achieve. born in Budapest in 1912. His parents recognized his talents early and enrolled him into music schools when he was five. After graduating from the prestigious Franz Liszt Academy, his blossoming career as a conductor was halted by conflict and he became a religious refugee. After the war, Mr. Schulte returned to prominence and was appointed music director by many renowned music companies, such as the Bavarian State Opera, Covent Garden Opera Company, and the Chicago Symphony Orchestra, helping them achieve even greater international recognition in the operatic and classical music world. Through the years, Georg Schulte's tremendous contributions to the music world have been recognized by many prestigious organizations and governments. In 1968, Queen Elizabeth II awarded him with the Most Excellent Order of the British Empire and knighted him in 1972. Renowned universities such as Harvard, Yale, Oxford, DePaul, and the Royal College of Music have awarded him with honorary fellowships and degrees. The music industry honored him with 31 Grammy Awards, 14 Grand Prix Mondial de Disque Awards, and a Grammy Lifetime Achievement Awards in 1996. Near the end of his fulfilling life, Mr. Schulte founded the World Orchestra for Peace, a large gathering of 81 musicians from 40 nations. In his own words, Mr. Schulte believed in the unique strength of music as an ambassador for peace. The orchestra debuted in Geneva to commemorate the 50th anniversary of the United Nations in 1995. Mr. Schulte passed away in 1997, but his legacy continues to thrive as the orchestra remains active to this day. Conscientious viewers, let's pause a moment for an important message. Please stay tuned to Supreme Master Television. Welcome back to our program featuring distinguished refugee artists around the world. In some of the darkest times of our history, exceptional individuals appear. Anna Judith Gertrude Helene Kerr was born in Germany to Jewish parents in 1923. Her father was a respected theater critic and columnist in Berlin, unafraid to speak out about injustices. One day before the national elections concluded, a kind police officer tipped the family of danger and they narrowly escaped to Switzerland. The next day, officers sent to arrest the family found an empty house. Miss Judith Kerr's family, now political refugees, moved to France and finally settled in England, where Judith began her successful career as a children's story writer. In 1968, she published her first self-illustrated children's book entitled The Tiger Who Came to Tea, followed by 30 more children's books, including the popular 17 book, The Mog series, based on her real-life cat. Judith also authored many novels, such as the award-winning semi-autobiographical Out of the Hitler Time trilogy, written in the perspective of a child during that challenging time. Her books have been translated into 20 different languages and have sold over 10 million copies around the world. Miss Kerr was appointed Officer of the Order of the British Empire in 2012 for her outstanding service to children's literature and Holocaust education. All through her life, she continued to support programs that help children around the world, especially refugee children. Judith Kerr passed away in 2019 at the age of 95, but her beloved books and illustrations continue to captivate the hearts of readers, both young and old. In the late 1930s, as the threat of imminent war created a humanitarian crisis across Europe,
a heroic group called the Emergency Rescue Committee was formed to save important artists and intellectuals in danger of persecution. Later renamed the International Rescue Committee, this courageous group was led by Varian Fry, a young journalist from the USA, dubbed the American Schindler. For over 13 harrowing months, the IRC was able to rescue over 1,500 prominent European thinkers and artists, including the leading Cubist sculptor Jacques Lipschitz and painter Max Ernst, founding member of Surrealism and pioneer of the Dada movement. Jacques Lipschitz was born in Lithuania in 1891, then part of the Russian Empire, but moved to Paris in 1909 to pursue his interest in sculpting art.
Inspired by Pablo Picasso and Georges Braque's Cubist paintings, Mr. Lipschitz incorporated this style into his lively three-dimensional sculpting.
His towering Cubist sculptures were highly lauded for their innovation and originality.
At the height of his success, oppression forced him into hiding until Varian Fry's rescue group helped him escape to the USA.
While in the US, Lipschitz attained international recognition with numerous major exhibitions and received important public commissions for his artwork. Late in his life, Mr. Lipschitz found comfort in his religious beliefs and devoted himself to daily prayers. After a long, fulfilling life, Mr. Jacques Lipschitz passed away in Capri, Italy.
He leaves behind a legacy of beautiful and thought-provoking sculptures displayed in public areas and famous museums around the world for many more generations to enjoy. Max Ernst, a painter, sculptor, graphic artist, and poet, was born in 1891 in Brühl, Germany.
Although he had no formal training, his interest in the arts was sparked at an early age by his father, who was an amateur painter. He studied philosophy at the University of Bonn, but decided to pursue his passion in art. Greatly influenced by the works of Pablo Picasso and post-impressionism artists like Vincent van Gogh and Paul Gauguin, he experimented and developed innovative painting techniques using various mediums. In 1914, Max Ernst was drafted into the German army
and was deeply traumatized by the cruelty and nonsensical nature of war.
After the conflict, he settled in Paris and immersed himself in his art, where he created unique avant-garde collages that depicted the ridiculousness of the world. In the 1920s, Mr. Ernst was inspired by the writings of Sigmund Freud and incorporated them into his art, which started Surrealism, an artistic revolution that embraced freedom of thought and rebelled against societal oppression of the mind. However,
his forward thinking was deemed dangerous, and he was listed as a target by the secret police. Thankfully, Varian Fry's heroic group managed to rescue and bring him to America. An immigrant in a new land, Mr. Ernst continued to innovate and create provocative artwork that inspired countless future artists, including a young Jackson Pollock, who later became a leader in the abstract expressionist movement. Mr. Max Ernst passed away in 1976, leaving behind a legacy of poignant artistic expressions for our world. For his heroic actions, Mr. Varian Fry, the brave leader of the International Rescue Committee, was later honored with the French Legion of Honor in 1967 and awarded Israel's Righteous Among Nations Medal in 1996.
Compassionate viewers, we hope you have enjoyed our program today, Refugee Artists, Ambassadors of Peace, Culture and Humanity, Part 103.
Please return this Saturday, June 20th, for Part 2.
Up next is Sharing Love Through Food, Loving Heart Vegan Supply, right after Noteworthy News. May the heavens protect and bless all artists for inspiring humanity with their love and talents.
Our programs offer many languages. Please visit suprememastertv.com/schedule and suprememastertv.com/AJAR.